Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel ServerGyan. My name is Dr. Lokendra Singh and today once again we are going to discuss about interview questions which are frequently asked from Linux admin and DevOps. If you are going to face interviews, so hopefully you are going to face these questions and we are going to discuss those questions. Okay, but before starting this video guys, I would like to request you to please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And do not forget to press bell icon as you will be notified for my upcoming videos. Okay, so first of all, let me tell you like which account is created on Linux installation. So the answer is root account is created. Reason being, when you open this file etc password, I'm going to explain you. So root user is by default created with user ID 0. All the user ID which have all the users which have user ID 0. So these are equivalent to your root user. Keep this thing in mind. And by default root user has bin bash shell because root user can log into system and can perform several activities. Okay, so second question is how to check memory stats and CPU stats. So the answer is if you want to check your memory, so command is free minus m for mb. And if you want to check your this particular stuff free hyphen k, so you can check in kb. And if you want to check in gb, if you have multiple gb, so you can check free hyphen g. Why I'm getting is zero, reason being because total amount of RAM is less than 1024 MB, so that is why it is showing is 0 gb. The same manner you can write here tb, pb and whatever amount you want, you can check. So by default it is showing here total like whatever is available stuff here, so that is showing here. Moreover, if you want to check man, and then you can run command free. So this is how guys you can check your process, that what all amount, what is used, what is shared, what is free and what is buffer cache, and all you can check here using man command. So whenever you are going to face interview and you need to dig yourself a bit more about the topic, so you are supposed to go for man pages for the command. Okay, so in the same manner vmstat is a command. So vmstat is a command which tells the stats of your memory, like what is free amount, what is buffer, what is cache. And there is a question guys I have for you, what is difference between buffer and cache? If you know, so please do write in comment box. And if you don't know, so no worries, I am going to explain within upcoming videos. So what is umask? So if we check that whenever any user creates a file, so maybe I'm going to create a file here as Lokendra. So whenever I create a file, so by default some permissions are granted on this. So how these permissions are defined? So these permissions are defined just because of umask. If I run a command umask, so it says that umask is 022. It means by default the umask of file is 666 and the umask of directory is 777. So if you talk about here, we can see that it is written 0. It means all the permissions are given. Here we can see read and nil. It means read permission has been revoked because 2 means write and which is not given to them. So the permission which you don't want to give, so that you will set as umask. It means users masking. Okay. Then after how to set the umask permanently for a user. So whenever you are going to set, so you can set, so you can run this command which is vim, and then after you can write the file. So vim command is not found here, vim command is not available as this is new OS I have installed and currently vi command is available. So you can write your umask here. You can go here and below this line you can write here umask and whatever you want, maybe 444, whatever you want you can write here. Fine. So this is how guys you set your umask. So I'm not going to save this file, reason being because I don't want to add new umask to my system. Okay, now how to check open ports on your system. So netstat is the command, netstat hyphen tunlp. So this is the command which says that how many ports are opened on your system. T for TCP, U for UDP, N for like available sockets, N for listening state, and P for process which is utilizing that particular. So like as we can see here, SSD, master, SSHD master and crond and UDP DHCP. So these sort of like process are utilizing this particular port. Okay, so what next? How to check open ports on remote server? So nmap is the command. Nmap. Nmap is the command. If that is not available, so you can install using this command: yum install nmap minus y. So this is how you can install your command. Okay, my system is a bit slow today because of network. So yum install nmap minus y is the command which you can utilize to install nmap. And after that, you can start utilizing that. So nmap is a particular command which can scan port on remote system as well. So I'm going to show you one example here. I'm going to take example of my own system as remote. So I will run command nmap hyphen capital A, then maybe localhost I'm going to run. So it will scan all the available ports on this particular system, like which ports are opened, port 22, 25, and so on, all the ports which are available on this particular server. So it will let you know. Fine. So nmap is the command to utilize this. Then after, how to check which services are enabled across reboot. So command is chkconfig hyphen hyphen list. So it will list all the commands which are available on which run level. So for example, network, so this is available across reboot. Your system is going to get IP address again and again until unless you specify that is not required anymore. Because wherever the service is enabled on run level 3 and 5. So most of time our system runs in run level 3 and 5. So that is it. That's how you can check. Now what is load average in Linux? So load average is defined as the average sum of number of process waiting in the run queue and number of process currently executed over the period of 1, 5 and 15 minutes. Using top and uptime command, you can, okay, top, uptime and top are the command which says that you can check your load on your Linux operating system. Fine. So we find the load average of Linux server how? Let me show you. The very first command is cat proc and load average. So this is the file where actual load is actual load of your server resides. Then after top command, you already know that this is your load average for 1 minute, this is for 5 and this is for 15 minutes. Fine. There is one more thing you can write. You can write here uptime command. So uptime is also command which say which lets you know about the information of your load average. Okay, then after, what is the partial backup? Partial backup means, for example, you have several partitions here. For example, I have here one only. So if you have slash home, slash backup, slash data, slash application, slash proc and all. So if you take backup of maybe slash or maybe of slash data, maybe of slash XYZ partition. So if you do not take backup of complete virtual machine or complete physical hardware server, so that is known as partial backup. So whatever is required, you take backup of that particular single partition or single mount point. Okay, how can we review reboot like boot message? So we have a command dmessage. Dmessage is a command which gathers information about your rebooting of system, like what particular process have been started and what is started at very first and after that what is executed and all. So after that, I have a question for you guys, like what are the fields in etc password file? So we have field first of all username, then after password, then after UID, then after GID, it means group ID, then after command for the user, that why user was created. Then after user's home directory, where is the home directory of user, then after user's login shell. So these are the field and these are separated by this delimiter command. Delimiter, fine. So let us try to open this file and let us try to understand that what happens is etc in which the password is a file. Fine. So ec2 hyphen user is username, x denotes for password, 1000 user ID, 1000 group ID, cloud user is comment for user, home ec2 user, home slash ec2 hyphen user is user's home directory and bin bash is login shell. Same here, if you want to check etc shadow, so etc shadow also contains the same stuff. like username, password hash, last password change, warning period, like when last password was changed, and this is like warning period. This is maximum number of days between password change. This is minimum number of days between password change. Fine. This is the day from, like, this is the expiry of password. So these sort of fields are here, which I have already explained within my previous video. So if you have yet not gone through them, so you can watch, as I'm going to share link of those videos within description box. Okay. So if you want to check final thing, like which file or which rpm provides /etc/shadow file, so you can run a command here which is known as rpm-qf, and after that you can give the file name etc, maybe shadow. So setup is a particular rpm which provides us this particular. And if you want to check password command, so setup is the command etc default and user add. So shadow-utils is the command which provides this particular stuff, like this particular command is, this particular file is provided by shadow-utils. If some of these files get corrupted, so you can reinstall this package and this file will be available in default mode. So this is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. These are some interview questions which are frequently asked, and hopefully within the next couple of videos I'm going to create on interview only, because this is a particular time when people are looking for job and people are facing these sort of interview questions. And recently I have faced a couple of questions, so I have included them. So thank you very much for watching. Have a good time. Happy learning from ServerGyan. If you have some questions related to interview, or you are interested to know something more about interview, so please do write in comment box. I shall be happy to explain that particular stuff. Thank you very much. Have a good time.